He's here. He's in the studio. He's joining us any second now, I swear.
Okay, we'll just wait.
So let's just kind of hang out and wait for him.
It's going to be special.
Oh, I'm telling you. When he walks on, the electricity in this room is just going to jump. He has that kind of charisma, that magnetism about him. It's going to drive people nuts.
You know?
Why, Eugene? Eugene Levy.
I was just in the next studio.
Who would have thought?
I'll tell you something. I was in the next studio crashing somebody special. I come in here, look what happens.
Oh,
John, how are you?
Good to see you, Gene.
Good to see you.
You know Martha?
Yes.
Eugene?
Hi, how are you, Eugene?
Come on and sit down.
Let me sit down here.
Guys, this is a shocker.
Isn't this something?
I can't believe it.
I really didn't expect this.
When did you get here?
I just walked in the door and I heard, you know, you were serious.
I said,
I can't believe it.
I heard he was in the neighborhood, but I didn't, you know, I was kind of half teasing
about
somebody.
You can't get away from me.
You know, it's a small world.
It is.
You know, think about what that means.
Jeez, that's funny that you just kind of happened on the set like this. So what have you been up to?
I haven't been working, John. It's been sad. You've been busy. I've been reading.
Yes, indeed.
Great things, too.
I've been very busy, yes. A lot of good things happening with me.
Because it's...
Nothing, huh?
No, not a thing.
Not a bite.
Well, let me give you a job, Eugene, since you've... I say it's been rough times. You're crashing other people's specials. Here at MTV, you can say that we will be back, but...
First, this word from the Hotz Professional Hair Care Appliances.
Jeez, that was terrible. Why would you do that? You know, maybe that...
The hats are for me. The sky's the limit and I must be free, yeah. Toss out the rules, I got the tools. The hats are for me. They got unlimited colors. They make head spinning styles. You put on the brush. It's a hot, hot collection. The hats are for me.
Dr. Seth Brundle's brilliant invention goes horribly wrong, and two beings merge into one. The Fly, rated R, starts Friday at theaters everywhere.
Which of these activities best describes MTV's Gonzo Summer? MTV's
Gonzo! Gonzo!
Gonzo! Gonzo Summer. Rock and roll 24 hours a day.
Blue. We're back here in the studio with special guest, Eugene Levy.
Please, I can't take the attention.
Joining John Candy. Now, I can see that there is unbelievable comedic chemistry between you two. It just happens.
It's kind of just arcing back and forth, is it?
It's kind of magical.
Yeah.
No, I can't explain it.
I can't either. I don't know. It's just kind of... So...
When did you first start to work together?
1973, Martha, that's when I first met John.
He was 7 years old.
mm-hmm. Yeah, he was young. He was a serious actor.
Yes.
And the wheel is coming full circle, I think.
Yes, it is.
So then we were in Second City and you know, the stage show, the theater.
That's where we met, yeah.
Before we started the television show, SCTV, and...
I was hired to go to, in Toronto, to go to Chicago with Second City, the theater group, and lasted there a year, and then I was traded back to Toronto, where we opened up the Fire Hall Theater, which is where Gene and I met with Joe Flaherty, Gilda Radner, Rosemary Radcliffe.
A whole bunch of people.
And then Dan Aykroyd came back. He left Second City for a while, came back on stage, and then we all ended up in Pasadena together for a while.
You know, it's a book. There's a book here.
And, well, we can tell a few chapters right now.
It's a novella.
And then the TV show spawned out of the theater group. And so we've been working together since 1974.
Long time.
And we were in a couple of films together.
So let's call this chapter, SCTV Goes to the Movies.
Okay.
I like that. Nice. I like that. I do.
You have a clip from the movie that features both of you in kind of a unusual situation. Why don't you set it up?
All right, Gene.
An unusual situation.
Toss it right to you.
Well, in this clip, Martha, we are running from the bad guys, and we are running from the police, and we have to resort to stealing some.
Well, this picture are bad guys as well. So.
Yeah, we have to resort to stealing some clothes from other people and
clever disguise.
Yeah.
Chicanery.
Okay.
And let's just see what happens.
And the hijinks begin.
Maybe you've seen these guys around us.
Oh, isn't he cute? And look at these muscles!
Get your hands off me. Who do you think you're talking to? I'm a police officer.
Oh, he gets so frisky when he sees a badge.
Hey.
Hello.
What are you doing later on tonight?
Take a walk, you jerk.
Let's trot. Why can't you look this good?
Mother Nature wasn't so kind to some of us.
I'm moving.
Oh, he touched me! I got my Christmas goose early.
Oh, aren't you the cheeky one?
Please, that's like the pot calling the kettle black.
Kind of a 1986 version of Some Like It Hot.
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
Well, that was fun. You know,
they
we
cut off a good part there right at the very end. I guess you'll have to go see the movie to see that.
What was the good part?
Oh, you didn't see? Oh, well, I guess I shouldn't get into this.
Yeah.
Kind of a cheeky little role there at the end.
Jen says, isn't he the cheeky little devil?
And
it's one of those
acting. Kind of bares his soul a little bit and other parts of his anatomy.
Would you care to do that now?
Come on.
Hmm?
Would I care to do that now?
Oh, drop
well,
your drawer. Show everybody for crying out loud. It's funny. Get a laugh. It'll get a laugh.
Maybe
drop
the privacy
drawers.
Of the control room. But it's a thrill being out on Hollywood Boulevard doing that scene, you know, getting a
hanging out,
200
so to speak.
People
yes.
On the other side of the street who happen to be up at 3:30 in the morning. I don't know. It's the movies. It's fun. It's, you know, you do it. John, you'll be doing that in your next film, won't you?
Oh, now after seeing you do it, sure, absolutely.
You want that Playgirl nomination?
Well, I know.
I'm afraid that's a must.
It's National Geographic again for me.
We're going to be back with Eugene and John. This is Lover Speaks, No More I Love Yous.
What?
From your precious face, are you still be wanting gone from so restless nights? My aching heart would bleed for you to see. Oh,
Here at MTV, we've done a lot of talking about the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, which is going to be in Cleveland. And I understand that it's being discussed at this point that the Schmanke brothers might be inducted. How are Stan and Yash doing?
Well, it actually were being thought of as being introduced into the Polka Hall of Fame in Chicago. Now, it's so nice to get the recognition of your peers, you know. You know, and you can make some money out of that too, which is always, you know, nice. You know, they give you a few bucks to go in there.
Possessed by the souls of Yash and Stan. What a thing to live with.
No, constantly it just comes out every now and then. It's frightening. No, well, anyway.
When are you guys going to make a video?
Well, we did our video, The Power to the Punk People,
was up many years ago. It made Time Magazine's top 20 video list in between the Rolling Stones and Donna Summer. We found the Schmengis.
Yes.
But
it was very popular with the kids.
Yes.
It's now, do you two know John Candy and Eugene Levy?
Well, I haven't personally had any, you know, dealings with them, but I hear they're pretty good guys.
Boy, this is tricky, huh?
Yeah.
Looking like ourselves, yeah, but talking like the child.
Maybe you could close your eyes and pretend it's the Schmink.
I kind of feel like I'm interviewing Sybil here.
Little bit, yeah.
Just happens every now and then, Martha. Just comes out. I'm sorry.
You were saying that again. You two have been together since 1974, about with SCTV, and the SCTV crew continues to work together. Is there projects in the future?
Well, we're hoping. We're hoping we got a special. We're looking to put together a special for CBS television in the fall, I think, of this year. It's a 9-man company. If everybody comes back, we've chatted with everybody in the cast, and everybody wants to do it, so we'll come back and kind of do a reunion show.
Which would be a lot of fun. Looking forward to that. Yeah.
Meanwhile, you have the movie Armed and Dangerous.
Yes.
And when does it open?
August 15, at a theater near you.
Are you nervous about the opening?
Yes, of course. I might even eat this paperclip. I'm not sure. That's how nervous I am.
He's such a private person, you know, things like that. This makes him nervous.
Yes.
You know, appearing on camera, talking, and, you know, just joking around. I'm a complete extrovert myself.
Yeah.
I can handle these things, you know, but I know. And
you're always good
with
pressure. You're good with pressure. I'm not. I can't deal with it.
Yeah.
You're good with pressure. You can deal with it.
We're all good with pressure, you know. We're all alike in that respect.
Well, I'm afraid that joke
is
about to a close.
That's it. We're off?
Really? The old
clock on the wall
is ticking, you know what I'm saying?
I thought we had 2 or 3 hours.
Well, I better get back to that special in the next video.
Yeah.
Wow. Eugene Levy, special guest, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for stopping by. Unbelievable.
Thank you.
We have on the way Madonna, Paul McCartney, Simple Minds video as well. It's all within 30 minutes. And once again, the two from Armed and Dangerous have been here in the studio. August 15th, the movie opens. See it.
Thank you.
Or else what?
I don't know.